We are going to have a look on an activity, refraction through a glass slab. For this, the requirements are the protractor, pencil, pins, scale, and glass slab. And a white paper. This white paper is placed on a thermocol sheet actually, or you can use a wooden block. And I'm pinning it such that the paper won't move. And now I have taken the glass slab, rectangular glass slab, and I'm drawing the outline of the rectangular glass slab. So this is the outline of the rectangular glass slab. Now I am placing a protractor at the top of the outer layer of the glass slab, and at perpendicular to the glass slab I am pointing now. The line perpendicular to the glass slab is our normal. Is a normal. This is our normal now. And now again, I'm taking the protractor and I'm taking the angle by placing exactly 90 at the normal. This is the 30 degrees angle. And now I am drawing a line to the normal. So this is our incident ray. I making an angle 30 degrees to the normal. It is making 30 degrees angle to the normal. Now again I am placing the glass slab. And here what we have to do is take two pins and place the two pins on the incident ray. We have drawn already the incident ray. On that incident ray I am placing the two pins like this. Now by seeing the two pins through the glass slab, as if they are straight, I have to place two more pins. See, now the two red pins are straight. Apart from that, by looking in through the glass slab, I am placing two more pins, green pins, and these pins should be also straight, should be in straight line. So the two red pins and two green pins should be in a straight line. So by looking into the glass slab, I have placed two pins also here. They are in straight line. And now take out the glass slab, take out the two pins, green pins, and now join the two dots where I have placed the pins. Join the dots to the glass slab. Yes, so this is our emergent ray and this is the point of incident on the glass slab. So I'm drawing a normal there. So this is a normal, and for the incident ray, at the point of incident I draw the normal again. Now these two points, the incident incident ray and emergent ray, both the two points I am joining, and I am extending the incident ray. See, incident ray, I am extending it. See, this is our extended incident ray. If the glass slab is not there, the light ray have to pass through this extended incident ray. Due to the glass slab, here we are getting the emergent ray. So the distance between this emergent ray and extended incident ray is our lateral shift. The shift is lateral shift, and here we can observe one thing. The light ray is traveling from A to glass, so it bent towards the normal here, and after that it is traveling from glass to air, so it is away from the normal. So if you measure the angle here, incident angle we have taken 30, so the emergent angle should be also 30. If 30 not comes, we may did some experimental error. That is due to pressing the pins by looking through the glass slab. We may have done an experimental error. So here I got the emergent ray angle is also 30 degrees. We can check it by the protractor, or we can check it by the by incidenting a laser light on the incident ray. If you incident a laser light on incident ray, if the emergent ray comes through the emergent ray we have drawn, then we have done correct. So let us check that by incidenting a laser light ray on the incident ray. See, here I am incidenting a laser light on the incident ray. So the light ray is emerging out on the emergent ray which I have drawn. See, yes, the light ray is emerging out from the emergent ray which I have drawn. So what we have done is correct. So this is an experiment. The refraction made by a glass slab.